Hello, everybody. Welcome to the What Sold Show, going over the week's worth of sales. Right after this. All right. So, today's Wednesday, November 10th. And, again, another awesome day. Can't be mad at all. Only one marketplace again. And, again, that's all we need. I know. You've noticed the new format here. We're only shooting 2 days a week because we have two-day shipping. I gotta be honest with you. Two-day shipping, or two-day handling, is probably the best thing we've ever done because it certainly takes the pressure off every day to film every day and ship every day. This is making life a lot easier for us. I hope you guys are still enjoying it. It seems like you are. So, getting into why you're here is what's sold. And what's sold is a couple things. A lot. First thing is this. It's a vintage postcard right here of Independence Hall. For those of you that don't know what Independence Hall is, that's where the Declaration of Independence was signed. So an important place in Philadelphia. $4 for this postcard plus shipping. We sold some bowls. These are Better Homes and Gardens bowls. They look like this. This right there. And then some of them are different colors. See? Fancy. They are kind of a plastic bowl. Got kind of the stressed look to them. $22 plus shipping for those. So the Cabbage Patch. Here she is. This is a 1980s Cabbage Patch doll. Red hair with pigtails right here. Purple outfit with dimples. Precious. She sold for $25 plus shipping. Something we don't sell a lot of. There's a few people out there that do sell a lot of this stuff. We don't. It's kind of a long ball type game. You're not going to sell them quickly. But we had one that came in some ephemera, and this is a Brennan? Beeren, I don't know. You know how I am. This is a yearbook from 1962, Ohio High School. $20 plus shipping. They are sellers, and they will sell. Reasonably. They'll sell reasonably. They're not quick. So if you're looking for fast money, yearbooks are not your business. I know John over at Cincinnati Picker sells quite a bit of them. And he does pretty well on them. But again, long ball. You're going to wait. That's for sure. Sold some of these. These are Lewis Marks figures. They are astronaut spacemen. And they're big, too. They're not small. They're just like plastic. They're like toy soldiers, but bigger. Think about like that. There's a... I guess that's supposed to be Neil holding the flag there. From 1970, Mark's 5.5-inch plastic astronaut spaceman. A lot of $14 plus shipping. The old Mark's toys, and it's M-A-R-X. The old Mark's toys sell really well. So, if you see them, you're definitely going to want to grab them. We had another lady come through and buy a very large pile of things off of us again. Same person, which is the first time that's happened to us. So I'm going to just quickly kind of run through all of this stuff that was bought. First thing is this. This is that purple, the cruise wear that we bought that we thought would actually sell pretty well, and it did not. Don't recommend buying stuff like this. And this is a sweatshirt and a pair of sweatpants that match. No, I don't know what we were thinking. Anyways, she bought this. She bought this Disney World shirt here, right here. She bought the Cabbage Patch. This one, a little newer Cabbage Patch. She's from 2004, a play-along Cabbage Patch. Her head is heavy, as you can see. She's... Anyways, yeah, Cabbage Patch right here. And then she bought a Seinfeld, may I say. Those pretzels are making me thirsty. Seinfeld shirt, new with the tags. Bought this Aeropostale t-shirt right here as well. Bought a... the thing's unfolding quickly for me today. Bought this. It's a long sleeve button down shirt. Bought this Carl's Jr. and or Hardee's ornament. Bought another shirt right here. This is a hoodie, knit like hoodie. Then bought this purple shirt. What is this purple shirt anyways? I believe this. Let's see. She bought things in two bursts because she had some problems with eBay right midway through it. So let's see. This is a vintage bright purple heart rose shirt. Single stitch Valentine shirt. This came from, I believe, that mystery box worth of single stitch stuff. And then bought, last but not least, this tie-dyed Harley shirt from Latrobe, Pennsylvania, where the Steelers hold their spring training. Well, they didn't this year, but maybe they won't ever again. All of that, $117.50. We're going to combine shipping for her. She's one of our new favorite customers because she's done this twice now. So, can't beat that. Sold another one of those little box trucks. Remember these from an auction a little while back? These are selling fairly well. Again, $13 for the whole box. We're already in the pure profit. So this sold $12 plus shipping. it's all money right there. So can't beat that. Sold an Under Armour shirt. White and like camo on the back. Under Armour shirt. New with the tags. $20 plus shipping there. Next goes out to a very special viewer. One of my very first viewers. I think you've bought a few other things, but I don't know that I've ever acknowledged the fact that you may be one of the very first viewers I've ever had. One of the very first people that commented positively on one of my videos way back a year and a half ago. William, commonly on our lives saying hello. William bought this. This is just a little Skull Copenhagen pin. Came from the Epic Estate Sale. Hat that we got. $4.85 for that. He says, thanks for the great information you provide. Bang a gong, get it on. Thank you so much, William. We're going to throw in some new stickers for you because I do believe you need the updated sticker. So we'll throw some stickers there for you, and we really appreciate you. Your continued loyalty to the show. Next up, we got a Men's Everlast shirt. It's like a shirt that you would commonly see somebody with bigger muscles than me wearing at the gym, more than likely. Anyways, size large, $10 plus shipping. Got that at a thrift store. I think we paid $1 for it. Next up, Sarah complains about people not buying the football kids, and they sell. Jimmy started it last one. This is fun doing this with the Cabbage Patch. Jimmy started it with the last one. And then this one sells immediately behind it to Elizabeth. I don't know if you're a viewer or not, Elizabeth, but either way, thank you. This one sold for $21.50. Plus shipping. More postcards. We had a run on postcards yesterday. I think this is the one. Looks like Ventura County to me. It's not. That's Chicago, Illinois. Here we go. This is Ventura. This looks more California. Ventura County, California. Ramona's old home. I don't know who Ramona is. But they took a picture and made it a postcard. $4.25 plus shipping for Ramona's old home. Keeping with the theme, more postcards. This is a vintage postcard of Sheldon Street in Michigan. Again, not 100% certain where Sheldon Street is, but there it is. And what a quaint looking street it is. Got horse and buggy in that one, so this is an old one. $4.25 plus shipping. Another bulk buy for yesterday comes in the form of magazines, which are in this laundry basket right here. You gotta get creative when you're taking big things of magazines up the stairs. These are all organic gardening magazines. We bought these at an auction. We paid $7 for all. I think $7. $7 or $10, somewhere around there. They all kind of run together after a while. Either way, they bought this one. This is a let's see, January 1963, so 12-issue lot from 1963, 12-issue lot from 1964, 1961, here they are, and 12-issue lot from 1962, all right there. You're just going to have to deal with that noise, because that was a perfect take on that, and I can't get rid of it because my phone dinged. So we're just going to deal with that. Three of the lots, $52 plus shipping. And then I guess this person found the fourth lot later, paid $20 plus shipping for that one. But we're going to refund that shipping back because chances are good this is all going to fit in a B box. So we're hoping to just refund the second one. So $72 plus shipping for organic gardening from the 60s. There you go. I'm going to move this basket back out of the way. I'm going to move on with our day. Next up is this. I've been waiting for this to sell. This is Super Mario Brothers U for a system I have never touched, which is happens to be the Wii U. It wasn't a very popular system. It was... In my estimation, it was a little ahead of its time. It was trying to kind of take everything that was popular from the Wii and bring it into like the touchscreen style of things. It's somewhere between, it is literally between the Wii and the Switch, but it's kind of a little bit of both of them. It's strange, but it could have worked. It didn't. This is Mario Brothers U for the Wii U right here. $15 plus shipping. Next up is this. I don't know what that says. According to eBay, it says it's Lupin the Third, Volume 1. Lupin the Third looks a little risque. Maybe not. I mean, it's not... Oh. Nope. It is. Lupin the Third. Hold it this way. Action Comics. Japanese Action Comics. $16 plus shipping. There is no English at all in that book, so... Hopefully whoever bought that can read Japanese. Sold an ornament, just a, your kind of run-of-the-mill glass ornament here. Nothing too spectacular, but still, $8. Plus shipping. Sold some cabinet cards. These are slowly becoming one of our better sellers. These are cabinet cards, a very blurry photograph of three women right here. The names are actually on the back here. This is Aunt Jean, Aunt-in-Law, and Grandma Hall. Aunt Jean, Auntie Law, and Grandma Hall. Right here. Mm-hmm. And then three sisters right here. Right here. It says on the back, Max's children. Michael, Helen, and Alex. Alice. Mildred. Look. That doesn't look like a Michael. Mildred, Helen, and Alice, right here. Don't know which one's which, but there they are. $19 for both of those, plus shipping. Big sale for the day. Comes in this form, right here. It's that Atari we bought on Monday's video. It's an Atari 2600 console. It works, too. Tested it the other day, and I was having fun playing those video games. Fun more just because of what it is, not fun because I'm any good at any of those games. I'm terrible. In fact, the one controller didn't work. Here it is right here. And controlling this is not easy when you're used to this. And yeah, this is not, yeah, it's hard. Anyways, yeah, it works. Seven games, all the games are behind me here. $105. Plus shipping. Oh man, when you sell one, the floodgates open. Here's another one. 1980s Cabbage Patch Doll, blonde hair, blue eyes, one tooth, with one dimple. Precious. She sold for $25 plus shipping. And last for today, I'm gonna point this out only because everybody's been asking if we're still selling them, and I'm skipping them most of the time because I figured you guys kind of got it by now. We sell Squishmallows. A lot of them. But I just wanted to bring it up. So yeah, we're still selling them. This is Tally, the gray tabby. I almost said cabby. The gray tabby cat. $20 plus shipping. This is going across the pond to the UK. Someone paid $62 in total to ship it. They are popular items, so gotta keep an eye out for those squishmallows. Unless you live around here, and then don't worry about it. Hello, everybody. Welcome. Today's Friday, November 12th. Happy Friday. We have some sales to go over with you, obviously, and today was good. Well, last 2 days were good. Sold two things on two marketplaces, Mercari and eBay. Only one thing on Mercari, and oddly enough, it's a pair of jeans. We don't sell a lot of clothes on Mercari. Most of the clothes go Poshmark or eBay. But yeah, sold a pair of Levi's size 42-32, 505s. $10 plus shipping for those. Moving on to eBay. We sold a cabinet card, and this one's a valuable one. This is a vintage cabinet card, Cleveland, Ohio police officer, right here. Typically, the firemen, police officers, postmen, cabinet cards are actually worth a fairly good bit of money. This one, $50. Yeah, $50 for this. Plus shipping. Sold some fish. They're Japanese koi fish. Right there. Two of those, and then two of these. Right here. This one here. $12 plus shipping for the koi fish. Sold some Nine West women's leopard print leggings, size XX. Here they are. They're very soft. They feel like they'd be very warm too. $14 plus shipping for those. Sold a lot of 30 black and white photographs from the 1930s and 40s. Kids and families and bride and groom, apparently, right there in the front. $12.50 for those, plus shipping. It's amazing to me that people really love this stuff. Other people's photos. Next up is another cabinet card, musician with a trumpet there. $15 plus shipping for that. This took forever to sell. And I thought it would sell right away. This is a Nike French Terry Club pullover sweatshirt, orange camo, as you can see from there. New with the tags. There's a tag right there. I thought this would sell a lot faster and for a little bit more money. We had it listed for 30. Took an offer for 20 plus shipping on it. It's just been with us for too long, and we got to turn some inventory. Sarah found these at a thrift store, and I guess they're kind of sought after. I really didn't know that people had problems coming across this stuff. But this is that, like, fake snow that you spray on your windows and stuff. Christmas time. $18 for a pair. Free shipping on those. Sold some more photographs. These are antique strip photos. So they're like the photos that you get in a photo booth there. $12.50 for those. Plus shipping. We found this at the bins. So we paid like a quarter for it. This is a vintage Izod Marriott Club. Marriott Orlando. Marriott. Or Marriott, whatever way you guys want to say it. Marriott Orlando World Center jacket. Medium. $15 plus shipping. So, yeah. Paying a quarter for it. Selling it for $15. That's great. It's just what we do. And then, I've been told that this is our last one. We actually had a buyer. It's actually one of you. I won't say who it is because it's Christmas time and I don't want to ruin anybody's Christmas gifts. So, this is a second to last one of these, thankfully. This is Playgirl from July 1989. Kirstie Alley is not. I want to say Kirstie Alley. I don't understand. I don't know. What's new in birth control, though? Very important article there. 1989 Playgirl, Benny Graham. She's on the cover there. $8 for that, plus shipping. And then we sold the first of several of these, the Dungeons and Dragons Monster Manual 2, $11 plus shipping. Not going to say thank you to who it is because, again, I don't know what Christmas gifts and such are going out. So thank you to whoever it is. And you know who you are that bought those things. Next up, another thing that sat for a while that we thought would sell a little faster, but it did sell. This is a 2012 Hello Kitty Build-A-Bear with leopard feet. The leopard feet right there. the Hello Kitty sold for $22.50 plus shipping. Everybody's favorite time of the video. Sold this little girl. This is a 1980s Cabbage Patch. Blonde hair, blue eyes, pink lace dress with one tooth. You can see her one tooth right there. She sold for $24 plus shipping. Most people would have thought this would have been a good buy, and I'm going to show it to you just because I don't want you to make the same mistake I did. Because this did not work out for us. This is one of those buys that should never have done. We bought like five of these things for $20 a piece, thinking they, wow, still smells, thinking they would be worth some money. This is a vintage Walt Disney Mickey and Minnie Mouse sweatshirt, size extra large, and they're vintage. The tag is, you know, relatively old. They've really never been out of the bag. I just took it out of the bag. But yeah, these aren't worth that much money. We've struggled to sell most of them, and this one we took a loss on because we want them out of here, because number one, they aren't selling, and number two, they smell like perfume, badly, I might add. $15 for the Mickey and Minnie Mouse sweatshirt. Steer clear of those if you can, plus shipping. So another Cabbage Patch. Sarah's actually sad to see this one go. There he is. This is Cabbage Patch Preemie, blue eyes, and an elephant romper. See the elephant right there? Precious. Sold for $18.50. Plus shipping. Sold some Christmas bulbs. These are satin vintage Christmas bulbs. I like the ones with the like string all over them. I don't know how to describe them. They're mini though. They're small. $10 plus shipping for those. Sold some marbles. This is we had a whole bunch of ones that were still in their own bag, and then we had some loose ones. And these are vintage C.E. Bogard marbles right here. They are cat eye marbles, sold for $18 plus shipping on those. So this back here, this came from the auction with some newer toys in it. This is Ultraman right here. Ultraman, Hummer Defense Fighter. Jet with figurines, new in the box. $5.99 at KB Toys on clearance. So we sold it for $24 plus shipping. $19.99 brand new. So went up in value. It's always good. Last two things. This is Christmas and Cat's apron. There it is. It's an apron with cats on it. I thought Sarah was going to keep this, but she didn't. $14 plus shipping for that. And last for today, our last one, Princess Leia Hallmark ornament right there. Not a vintage one. From 1998. $8 plus shipping. And that's going to wrap it up for us this week. Starting tomorrow, we're going to be starting a new What Sold that will come out next Wednesday. And then me, all by myself, going to an auction on Saturday. It's going to be a video on that coming on Monday. Should be pretty entertaining seeing what I got. Also seeing what Sarah yells at me about for spending too much money. That coming up Monday, and then Sunday, Pittsburgh Picker Live with me and Sarah. So if you want to get notifications for all of that, hit that subscribe button for me and you'll get notified whenever we do all this stuff. It'll be fun. You'll love it. And if you like this video, hit the thumbs up on your way out. I appreciate that too. That's it for this weekend. Or this week. Did it reverse last night? That's it for this week. Bye.
Good day, sir!